Ben is in constant pain. He's been waiting for over 20 months for surgery on an abscess, but has had his procedure delayed because of NHS strikes.
It's been really frustrating, and it's had a huge impact on my life. You know, I run several businesses, but one particular business where I need to go and see people, and there have been days when I physically cannot go.
Ben's agony will almost certainly continue. Junior doctors have voted to extend their industrial action, and now, for the first time ever, they'll strike together with consultants. It means for 4 days in October, the NHS will be brought to a halt for everything except emergencies.
Both consultants and junior doctors have been ignored by our government and Mr. Sunak for, you know, months on end, despite already having striked.
The responsibility for the huge waiting list lies squarely with the government. And one of the size of that waiting list is one of the drivers for consultants and junior doctors to take action.
More than 800,000 NHS appointments have had to be cancelled since health workers' strike started 8 months ago. The waiting list now stands at over 7 million. Joint strike action by consultants and junior doctors is the worst case scenario. This is what NHS trust leaders were dreading. One trust leader I spoke to said, "This is a nightmare. It simply can't be allowed to happen." But for 4 days, it is going to happen unless there's a breakthrough, and that doesn't look likely. Bringing down the waiting list is one of Rishi Sunak's key pledges. He blames the industrial action for the record numbers waiting. This joint action will put more pressure on both sides to find a resolution, and quickly.
The important thing is to say to both the government and to the doctors that we have got to see some imagination, some pragmatism, some compromise to get through this.
The health secretary says the strikes are disappointing and his door is open for discussions, but not about pay. His offer is final. The BMA says it will not back down. For Ben and millions of other patients, it means more agonising uncertainty. Ashish Joshi, Sky News in central London.